has been a tremendous partner and advocate for the Indian community and his constituents. I know that we all look forward to continuing our work together. Last September, I, together with my husband and an impressive New Jersey delegation, had the pleasure of visiting 5 Indian states in a scant 7 days. A highlight of all was Hyderabad, where we met with Chief Minister KTR and signed a sister state partnership with Telangana. We are very interested in growing the Telugu film industry here in New Jersey and look forward to supporting Tollywood. So again, thank you for your warm welcome. It is my privilege to be here in honor of International Women's Day. I am a firm believer that women are change makers, and it is to the great benefit of society that we ensure that women are empowered, educated, healthy, and involved in their communities. When I began my career, and for many years after, I was often the only woman in a room full of men. Then, women lacked representation in leadership positions, were not paid equally to their male counterparts, and often did not receive the same benefits as their male colleagues. In short, we faced many of the same workplace challenges as we do today. But we have made some progress. One of the first things Phil did as governor was to sign New Jersey's Equal Pay Act, ensuring equal pay for equal work. We currently have 37 women serving in the New Jersey State Legislature. And we are actively investing in women-led businesses through a partnership with Golden Seeds and the New Jersey Economic Development Authority. Because, as we know, women are an integral part of developing a diverse innovation economy. And all indicators show that having women in leadership roles makes organizations more creative and more lucrative. With this in mind, one of the things I'm most proud of in our administration is the number of women leading cabinet positions. For the first time in New Jersey's 242-year history, a majority of cabinet appointments by the governor has been women. We have already seen what happens when opportunities for women are overlooked and when their resources are underfunded because policy leaders have excluded women's voices. These issues that inhibit our overall success and limit our independence are issues that we are tackling head-on, sometimes legislatively. However, some of the most influential changes will come from the examples set for our daughters, sisters, and friends. As women, we must lead the way to enact the changes that we want to see. As a working mother, I understand the challenges that you all face in balancing all the demands on your time, on top of striving to maintain strong cultural ties to your Telugu heritage. By acting as leaders and demonstrating the value of our presence in academics, business, government, and beyond, we show our children and the world the impact that women can make when we are healthy and financially independent. And at a time when in many countries, women's most basic rights are still denied, it is our solemn duty to advocate for those who cannot advocate for themselves. Indeed, in many places around the world, women do not have access to education, to the right to travel freely. There are innumerable accounts of abuse and exploitation, all underscoring the truth that women are still generally unsafe in pockets around the world. Today, on International Women's Day, as we celebrate the many incredible achievements of women, as we look back at how far the women's movement has taken us, we cannot forget that there is still so very much work to be done. But if I am certain of one thing, it is that we will ultimately prevail. We may still have setbacks, but we will prevail. Here in New Jersey, across the United States, in India, and all around the world. Thank you for having me, and have a fantastic day today.
Thank you so much, Mrs. Murphy. I would like to call upon the board once again, just to say thank you and honor our chief guest for this afternoon. And please, the ladies too can join. Swarnagar Mirpada. It's been an inspiring, thank you so much. We heard so much about commitment towards women and welfare. And taking the time to come here is awesome, awesome. We're really very, very honored. Honored to be here.
Tracy Armstrong is a member attorney at law at Billens firm, Billens Goldman and Spitzer PA. She has over 25 years of experience representing employers across industry sectors in all aspects of federal and state labor and employment law, which she is going to talk about. She also has a niche with medical practices. She does represent doctors writing contracts and things like that for the employees about the discrimination law and FMLA and all that. Apart from her professional activities, off hours, I'm very impressed with this, off hours, Ms. Armstrong devotes her time to a variety of charitable causes, volunteer efforts, and as an active member of New Jersey Legal Association, she has a blog. And also in 2018, Ms. Armstrong received the 2018 Women of Distinction Award from the Girl Scouts of the Jersey Shore. Scout said, inspiring the girls to become leaders of tomorrow. I invite Tracy. Tracy Armstrong is a member attorney at law at Billens firm, Billens Goldman and Spitzer PA. She has over 25 years of experience representing employers across industry sectors in all aspects of federal and state labor and employment law, which she is going to talk about. She also has a niche with medical practices. She does represent doctors writing contracts and things like that for the employees about the discrimination law and FMLA and all that. Apart from her professional activities, off hours, I'm very impressed with this, off hours, Ms. Armstrong devotes her time to a very variety of charitable causes, volunteer efforts, and as an active member of New Jersey Legal Association, she has a blog. And also in 2018, Ms. Armstrong received the 2018 Women of Distinction Award from the Girl Scouts of the Jersey Shore. Scouts said, inspiring the girls to become leaders of tomorrow. I invite Tracy.
On employment law, I said, well, how much time do I have? So I'm starting my timer. Because she said to me 12 minutes, and I went, what? And I said, I normally do this in like 2 hours. She said, okay, 15 minutes. So I'm gonna talk really, really fast. I will be here after if you have questions. Because when you say the word employment law, the amount of information it encompasses is mind-boggling. And what I don't want you to have happen as business owners is to have your first encounter with employment law be because of the following: the U.S. Department of Labor, the New Jersey Department of Labor, the EEOC, the Division on Civil Rights, or federal or state court comes knocking on your door. Because that is an uncomfortable position to be in. So knowledge is power. And in order to have that power in employment law, you have to have an understanding of what laws are affecting your business and your employees. So first and foremost, minimum wage. It is going up every January, whether you want it to or not. Make sure you know what minimum wage is. Make sure you are paying your employees minimum wage. Overtime. Overtime is paid at time and a half for every minute that is worked over 40 hours a week. Those concepts seem very simple, but the problem with overtime becomes the following. You and I are engaging in a conversation and I say to you, why isn't that person paid overtime? And you say, because I pay them a salary. I'm gonna say, so what? That's not the end of the conversation. Why are you able to pay them a salary? They have to meet the duties test. It is not just I pay them a salary. They don't meet the duties test, you better be paying them overtime. If you don't know what the duties tests are, do me a favor, go to the Willens.com website, find my blog, type in exempt employees, you'll find the duties test for the different categories to be exempt. Why are those important? Because right now what we are seeing a rise in is class actions and collective actions against employers. And what do I mean by that? If you are not paying people correctly, I'll give you an example. Assistant managers. Just because you call someone an assistant manager doesn't make it so. If the dog walks in the room and I tell you it's a duck, guess what it is? It's still a dog. Even though I'm telling you it's a duck. So if you have an assistant manager, you better make sure that assistant manager's job meets the requirements to be exempt from overtime. If not, that assistant manager, all your assistant managers from years and years ago will file a lawsuit, and it may be a class action or a collective action. And that is a painful process to go through. And it is becoming more and more important because you can do something about it as a business owner. You can have a class action or a collective action waiver that you get your employees to sign that says, hey, you're gonna come after me, you're gonna come after me one at a time. But that goes on to be careful what you wish for. Ask Chipotle. They had all their employees sign a class action waiver. Guess how many lawsuits they're defending now? About 6,000. Because they had to come after them one at a time. Why is this information important? It's important because we've had a lot of changes to employment law. One of the most significant changes happened recently. It's called the wage theft law. Anybody heard of the wage theft law? True story. I was speaking to a group I come out, I'm driving down 287, there's a billboard, and it says, are you the victim of wage theft? Call. And then there's a number. Why is that important? Because all those things I told you about minimum wage and overtime and employees being able to come after you, it used to be for 2 years. Now it's for six. So we go from a 2-year statute of limitation to a six. Why is that important? Because think of the following. Not only did it go to six, it went to treble damages. So let's take an example. You have an employee, you make a $10,000 mistake. You don't pay him $10,000 worth of overtime for 1 year. 1 year times six is $60,000. It's treble damages. 60 times three is $180,000. Then you're gonna pay the plaintiff's lawyers all their fees. So I go from $180,000 to about $250,000 very quickly. So your $10,000 mistake now just cost your business $250,000. So it's important that you are dotting your I's and crossing your T's when it comes to compensating your employees, because the wage theft law is out there. It also makes it a crime not to pay your employees appropriately. And most importantly for business owners, I was at a seminar once and someone said, well, what about piercing the corporate veil? The reason we have these business entities is to protect the individuals. Guess what? You can be individually liable. It doesn't matter. They don't have to pierce the corporate veil. They can come after you individually. And the people in charge of making payments, like your poor HR person, can be named individually. So it's important to understand what our employees are entitled to earn and make sure we're paying them appropriately. You heard the governor's wife talk about the Equal Pay Act. For me, the Equal Pay Act is very interesting for the following reason. Under federal law, we had an Equal Pay Act for a long time, but New Jersey's Equal Pay Act was a little bit more extensive. It said equal pay not only for women based on gender, but based on any protected class, age, race, religion, national origin. And it told employers, guess what? You have an affirmative obligation to make sure you're not violating this law, so you better do an audit. I had a client who did an audit, came to me and he said, I have four vice presidents, one's a woman. I think he's bragging, 25% women. No. He said, I pay her $20,000 a year less than the men. I said, why? And he said, I don't know. And I said, that is a problem. Because you need to tell me she doesn't have a college degree, she has less experience, but I don't know is not an answer. And you cannot do this. You must raise the individual who is not making the appropriate salary, not lower the other three. Now, interestingly enough, on the heels of the Equal Pay Act, we had a new law in January. Anybody know what it is? What can you not ask for starting January 1st if you interview an employee, a prospective employee? Do not ask them what their previous salary was. It is a violation of the law. You cannot ask. Why is that? Because the theory is we're perpetuating what the governor's wife was talking about, this pay disparity. If I come to you and I say, I made $40,000 a year at my last job, and you're like, oh, I'm paying people $75 to do this, I can probably get her for $50, you're violating the law. Because if that job is worth $75, you have to offer me $75. And there was a recent case in the Ninth Circuit of the United States who said, no, that is the exact purpose. So if someone comes in and says, I only want $40, and you know that job is worth $75, you have to pay $75 or you are violating the law. It is equal pay for equal work. Moving on, and I'm going down the lawn, I'm basically reading you my grocery list of things that keep me up at night. Paid sick leave. If you employ one employee, you better be providing them paid sick leave. Please do not tell me they work part-time. It does not matter. There are very, very few exceptions. They should be earning 1 hour for every 30 worked. It is complicated, there are carryovers. But if you have one employee, you should be implementing paid sick leave. In New Jersey, we have not only posters, but you have distributions you should be making. There are certain distributions that you need to make if you have just one employee. There are other distributions you make when you have 10 employees, 25, 50, so it goes up. You need to be making those distributions. In New Jersey, last June, we changed our Leave Act. For those those of you that used to think I don't have 50 employees, protected leave doesn't apply to me. New Jersey Family Leave Act dropped down to 30 last June. It doesn't match the federal law anymore. If you have one employee, you better be talking to your employees about family leave insurance. It is pay, it is not a job holding statute. If you have 25 or more employees, you better know about the New Jersey Safe Act, which is the Domestic Violence Act that gives people protected time off. Near and dear to my heart, in addition to being an employment lawyer, I am on the Cannabis Law Committee for the state of New Jersey. So I'm here to tell you, no, your employees cannot come to work high. Although medical marijuana is now permissible in the state of New Jersey. So if you do any type of drug testing, A, you better make sure the drug testing complies with the law and that you can drug test. And B, if you have someone who hits for marijuana, you better speak to an employment lawyer about what you can and cannot do based on that positive test. Moving on to having employees. Remember I told you about those class action waivers? The other things that you need to be considering are arbitration agreements. Do I want to have my employees arbitrate claims rather than go to a jury trial? And there are positives and negatives for entering into arbitration agreements. Restrictive covenants. Do I want to have my employees sign restrictive covenants, which can include non-competes, non-solicitations of employees, non-solicitations of my customer, one or all three of those. And you want to decide, who of my employees do I want to have them sign? Who do I not want to have them sign? And you may have different types of agreements. The governor's office has been very active in signing these employment laws into effect. There's one out there that hasn't been signed yet, but I'm here to tell you that it's coming. Anybody know what it's about? They just issued, I haven't read it yet, but about 2 weeks ago, they issued two reports. You may know? It's on harassment. There are two reports out there. So New York passed a law, said I don't care if you have one employee or 1,000 employees, you better provide anti-harassment training, you better have a policy. And you better make sure it's interactive. So somebody like me or somebody else better be there so people can answer questions. Well, New Jersey, when New York does something good, we go, ooh, that's a good idea. Guess what? I'm here to tell you there will be mandatory anti-harassment training. If you are an employer and you say, I don't want to have a handbook, I am telling you one of the things you must have, including some of the policies I've talked about that you must distribute, you absolutely should have, and you probably will under the law, have to have an anti-harassment policy very soon. If you want a defense to a case, it can't be, I didn't know. Because if you didn't know because you don't have a policy, the law does not care. You have to tell your employees what harassment is. You have to tell them how to complain. And you have to do something about it if they complain. If you don't do any one of those steps, you're going to be liable as an employer. And yes, they will try and come after you individually. So if you don't have a handbook, you certainly should. Last, but certainly not least, actually it's not going to be last, but close to last, second to last, I want all of you to do me a couple favors. If you own a business, when you're done here today, I want you to call your insurance agent and I want you to say, do I have EPLI insurance? Do I have employment practices liability insurance? And what that is it gets you coverage if you have one of these issues. And you want to know, what's my deductible? What's my coverage? And oh, by the way, am I covered for wage and hour issues? Not for the payment, but for the defense costs. If you do not have that, you must get it. The cost to defending these issues goes up exponentially very quickly. Last but not least, in March of this year, took effect in New Jersey. It's a new transit law that you have to provide to employees an opportunity to have transit costs paid out of pre-tax dollars. If you have not done it, please look into it. Please find out what you need to do. So my last comment to you is, I started this by telling you I believe knowledge is power, and I do believe that. So I'm going to leave on my table, there are the exact outline that I read. There are my cards, but most important for me, there's a sign up for a blog. We blog once a week on employment law issues. We try and make them relevant. We don't blog on esoteric points of the law. We blog on things that affect employers. If you would like to receive the blog, it is free legal advice. All you need to do is sign up with your email address and we'll sign you up for the blog. So I thank you very much for your time and your attention. And if you have any questions, I will be here. Thank you.
నా పేరు ఇందిరా శ్రీరామ్రెడ్డి. టాటా నేషనల్ ఉమెన్స్ చైర్గా నేను నిర్వహిస్తున్నాను. చాలా సంతోషంగా ఉంది ఇవాళ మేమందరం ఇవాళ దగ్గరకు వచ్చాము టు సెలబ్రేట్ ఉమెన్స్ డే అండ్ వెరీ హ్యాపీ టు సీ సో మెనీ ఉమెన్ అవుట్ హియర్ స్పెండింగ్ దిస్ ప్రెషియస్ మూమెంట్స్ విత్ అస్ అండ్ వెరీ థ్యాంక్ఫుల్. అలాగే మనకి ఇవాళ ట్రేసీ ఆర్మ్స్ట్రాంగ్ గారు వచ్చారు, అటార్నీ ఎట్ లా, అండ్ షీస్ హియర్ టు షేర్ హర్ బిజినెస్ ఆంటర్ప్రెనల్ స్కిల్ సెట్స్ అండ్ pitfalls and many things. So thank you, Mrs. Armstrong. So would you like to say a few words?
Sure. First of all, I want to thank you for inviting me to be here to celebrate International Women's Day. It is fantastic to see so many women here and to have the opportunity to speak to them about employment law issues that may affect the businesses that they're in. And that includes things like minimum wage and overtime. And on International Women's Day, we need to be reminded of the Equal Pay Act that came into effect in New Jersey last year. And it is a significant impact because it's not only equal pay based on gender, but it's based on any protected class, such as age, race, and religion. And it requires employers to look at their pay structure and make sure that they are paying people equal pay for equal work. And if they find a disparity, the goal is to increase the person who is not being paid appropriately, not to decrease the other individuals. So it is a significant event, not only for women, but for all protected classes.
Thank you. Thank you so much, Mrs. Tracy Armstrong. Vijay Garu.
ఈ రోజు ఇక్కడికి వచ్చిన అందరు మహిళలకి
మన దగ్గర ఆల్సో వి హావ్ దిస్ ఆఫ్టర్నూన్ విజయ.
సో ఐ
లాట్ ఆఫ్ యంగ్ ఉమెన్ హియర్ హు షేరింగ్ దేర్ ఎంతూజియాజం, సో వీ వుడ్ లైక్ టు టేక్ ఈచ్ వన్స్ ఒపీనియన్. విజయ నాదల గారు ఇవాళ మన రీజనల్ కోఆర్డినేటర్ ఫర్ న్యూజెర్సీ, వుడ్ యూ లైక్ టు సే ఫ్యూ మూమెంట్? We would like to also take opinions from our young energetic Shivani Aita, regional coordinator for New Jersey, ATA. So Shivani, what's your experience today?
హలో ఎవ్రీవన్. ఈరోజు మేము రాయల్ ఆల్బర్ట్ ప్యాలెస్లో March 8, 2020 ఉమెన్స్ డే సెలబ్రేట్ చేసుకుంటున్నాము. అండ్ ఈ ఇయర్ థీమ్ వచ్చేసి అందరికి తెలుసు, ఈచ్ ఫర్ ఈక్వల్. అండ్ ఇక్కడ చాలా బాగుందండి. అండ్ ఆల్మోస్ట్ మోర్ దెన్ 300 ప్లస్ వచ్చారు. అండ్ వీఆర్ ఆల్ హ్యావింగ్ ఫన్. థ్యాంక్ యూ సో మచ్.
థ్యాంక్ యూ.
నేను విజయ నాదెల్లా, ఆటా రీజనల్ కోఆర్డినేటర్ మాట్లాడుతున్నాను. ఇక్కడ ఈరోజు రాయల్ ఆల్బర్ట్ ప్యాలెస్లో మేమందరం మహిళా దినోత్సవాన్ని సెలబ్రేట్ చేసుకుంటున్నాము. ఇక్కడ ముఖ్య అతిథులుగా మనకి మిసెస్ గవర్నర్ అండ్ అటార్నీ అట్ లా అండ్ ఫిజీషియన్స్ వీళ్ళందరూ వచ్చి మనకి సమగ్రమైన సమాచారాన్ని ఉపదేశించడం అయింది. మన అందరం కూడా ఈరోజు ఈక్వాలిటీ గురించి చేసుకుంటున్నాము. ఈక్వాలిటీ, జెండర్ ఈక్వాలిటీ అండ్ పే ఈక్వాలిటీ అండ్ ఈక్వల్ ఆపర్చునిటీస్. ఇట్స్ నాట్ జస్ట్ మెన్ ఈక్వల్ టు ఉమెన్, ఇట్స్ అబౌట్ మెనీ అదర్ things. There are still many women who doesn't have the equality rights in the world. We are all talking about the same thing here. Yeah. And thank you everyone for coming here. Thank you.
Yeah. On stage. And also the ladies team, please come on the dais. We're very happy for spending this valuable time with us, precious moments. Exchanging all the good ideas with ATA, American Telugu Association. Just a small token of appreciation. So, please.
Picture.
Yes, one second. We have some energetic. Hello. All of you, please do. Okay, please come. Please join us.
టూ పీపుల్ తరండి ఇటు వైపు రండి
కొద్దిగా వసంత్ గారు వస్తారా కూర్చోండి దీపా ప్లీజ్ కమ్ జాయిన్ కమ్ 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 వసంత్ గారు వస్తున్నారా
రెడీ వన్ టూ
పేరు మాధవి అరువా నేను ప్రోగ్రామ్ మేనేజర్గా వర్క్ చేస్తున్నాను సో ఈరోజు ఆటా తరఫున అందరికీ ఇంటర్నేషనల్ ఉమెన్స్ డే ఈరోజు మేము రాయల్ ఆల్బర్ట్ ప్యాలెస్లో ఆటా ఉమెన్స్ డే సెలబ్రేట్ చేసుకుంటున్నాము సో మోర్ దెన్ 500 ఉమెన్ సెలబ్రేట్ చేశారు అండ్ ఇయర్ థీమ్ వచ్చేసి ఈక్వల్ ఫర్ ఉమెన్ సో ఐ షుడ్ రిక్వెస్ట్ ఆల్ ద ఉమెన్ అందరూ మీ రైట్స్ కోసం మీరు ఫైట్ చేయండి అండ్ ఆల్ ద మెన్ షుడ్ ఆల్సో గివ్ ఈక్వల్ రైట్స్ టు దేర్ డాటర్స్ అండ్ వైఫ్స్ సో దట్ విల్ హెల్ప్ ద నేషన్ టు గ్రో థ్యాంక్ యూ ఆల్
Okay, 1, 2, 3, smile everyone. One more. And now we can have the symbol. Okay, just make sure you don't cover your face when you do that. Put it below your face. Okay? Okay, 1, 2, 3, smile everyone. One more. One last. Thank you.
మహిళా మండలందరూ మీరు లేకుండా ఏది లేదు ఇందాక వారు చెప్పినట్టు ఎవరి డే ఉమెన్స్ డే నాటి వాళ్ళు డే ఎందుకంటే అమ్మ చెల్లి అక్క కూతురు అందరూ కూడా ముఖ్యమే కాబట్టి మీ అందరికి కూడా ఎల్లవేళ మీరు చల్లగా ఉండాలని ఆ సాయిరాన్ని కోరుకుంటూ చిన్న ఆశీర్వచనం ఓం యో వైదాం బ్రహ్మణ వేద అమృతేన వ్రతాం పరేం తస్మై బ్రహ్మజ బ్రహ్మజ ఆయుక్తేర్థం ప్రజాందతః భాగదేగేనైవైనం ప్రణయతి బ్రాహ్మణా ఋషయ ఉద్ధరేత్ బ్రాహ్మణో వై సర్వ దేవతాః సర్వాభిరేవైనం దేవతాభిరుద్ధరతి యావదేర్వై దేవతా స్తాస్సర్వ వేదవిధి బ్రాహ్మణే వసంతి తస్మాత్ బ్రాహ్మణేభ్యో వేదవిభ్యో దివే దివే నమస్కరీయాన్నాశీలంకీర్తేదేవదీ శతంజీవ శ్రదవృద్ధమాన ఇవనిగమో భవతి శతమితి శతం దీర్ఘమాయుః శతమానం భవతి శతాయ పురుష శతేంద్రియ ఆయుష్యేవేంద్రియ ప్రతిష్టతి ఎవరిబడి ఆయురారోగ్య ఐశ్వర్యాభివృద్ధిరస్తు సాయినాథ కరుణ కటాక్ష సిద్ధిరస్తు సర్వే జన సుఖినో భవంతు సమస్త లోక సుఖినో భవంతు
థాంక్ యు ఆర్ వి రెడీ విత్ ది రిజల్ట్స్ యా ఓకే ఇస్ ది టీమ్ హియర్ ఇస్ ది గిఫ్ట్స్ రెడీ నందిని ఓకే ఫస్ట్ ప్రైజ్ ఎవర్ కమ్ వి హావ్ ది విన్నర్స్ సో వన్ సెకండ్ షష్ లక్ష్మి గారు లక్ష్మీ దేవినేని గారు ప్లీజ్ కమ్ ఆన్ ద డైస్ వెరీ ఎనర్జెటిక్ ఎంథూసియాస్టిక్ లేడీ అగైన్ ఐ ఆల్వేస్ అడ్మైర్డ్ హర్ ఆల్ త్రూ అవుట్ ద ఫంక్షన్స్ హ్యూజ్ రౌండ్ ఆఫ్ అప్లాస్ ఫర్ జాయినింగ్ అండ్ బీయింగ్ విత్ అస్ టుడే థ్యాంక్ యూ లక్ష్మి గారు సో వితౌట్ మచ్ అడ్ యూ ఎస్ శశి
థ్యాంక్ యూ We are going to be announcing 4 winners, so I'm going to start from the back. At number 4th position is Dr. Banu Rekha. Please give her a big hand. Dr. Banu Rekha, please come on stage.
Pandurekha, please come on the dais. There she walks in beauty and grace. Good job. Thank you for coming today.
Thank you so much, Manigaru.
And in the third position is Lakshmi. Give her a big hand. Lakshmi, please make your way to the stage.
Thank you so much.
She's got the mimosa color on today.
Good job.
Happy. Good job. Thank you.
You have a takeaway, huh? Yes, third prize, please.
Second prize goes to Aishwarya. She was a last minute participant, so that was awesome. Aren't you glad you signed up?
Good job, Nana. Wonderful.
Good job. Congratulations.
Photo.
You get a sign. Oh, beautiful. You want to open it and see? Show us.
Photo.
And we have the first prize winner. Any guesses?
Okay, sorry. You don't have to be a student. Okay, sir. Open just to me.
Sorry.
Woo! Nice. Very beautiful.
Nice.
Just as beautiful as you, Aishwarya.
Good job, Amma. Very good sportive, enthusiastic.
So the first prize goes to Kiran Mai. Put your hands together. You were my favorite pick too. I'm so glad you won. Congratulations. There is the crowning of the queen. Everybody, please put your hands together again for all the participants who participated in the fashion show. It is not easy to be up on stage and participate in this, so every one of you is a winner. Good job, everyone.
You want to open that and show us? Yeah. Unbelievable.
Woo!
Thank you so much.
Madhavi Aruva Andi, on behalf of ATA, I would like to wish Andariki, all women, happy Women's Day. And I would like to urge all the men to give equal rights for their daughters and wives.
Hi, na peru Indu Basa. Mem ee roju ikkada Albert Palace Edison lo International Women's Day 2020 celebrate cheskoniki ikkada chaala mandi aadollu vachinaru. Idantha aata nirvahisthunna ee karyakramamlo chaala mandi aadollu ఏది కూడా లెక్క చేయకుండా వెదర్ కానీ మేము ఈ వైరస్ జరుగుతున్న ఈ డేస్లో కూడా అసలు అన్నీ పట్టించుకోకుండా మేమందరం ఒకటి ఆడోళ్ళకి ఒకరికి మేము సపోర్ట్ ఉన్నాము అని చెప్పనికి ఇంతమంది ఆడోళ్ళు ఇక్కడ జమ అయినరు. సూపర్గా ప్రోగ్రామ్ జరుగుతుంది, లోపల ఆటలు పాటలు, చాలామంది విమెన్ ముందుకొచ్చి గుడ్ విమెన్ స్పీకర్స్. ఈరోజు ఎందుకు మనం ఇట్లా సెలబ్రేట్ చేసుకోవాలి అని చాలా బాగా చెప్తున్నారు. ఐఎమ్ ప్రౌడ్ టు బి విమెన్, ఐఎమ్ ప్రౌడ్ టు బి ఎ ఫెమినిస్ట్. థ్యాంక్ యూ.
హలో, నా పేరు దీపికా బైలం. నేను ఈరోజు రాయల్ ఆల్బర్ట్స్ ప్యాలెస్ మార్చ్ 2020 ఉమెన్స్ డే సెలబ్రేట్ చేసుకోవడానికి వచ్చాను. అండ్ వీఆర్ సెలబ్రేటింగ్ ఉమెన్స్ డే హియర్ విత్ అ లాట్ ఆఫ్ అదర్ లేడీస్. అరౌండ్ 400-500 పీపుల్ వచ్చారు ఇక్కడ. అండ్ ఎవ్రీ ఇయర్ ఆటా సెలబ్రేట్స్ దిస్. అండ్ ప్లీజ్ సబ్స్క్రైబ్ టు తెలుగు ఎన్ఆర్ఏ రేడియో. థ్యాంక్ యూ.
అందరికీ నమస్కారం. నా పేరు భాను మాగంటి, న్యూజెర్సీ నుంచి ఉంటాను. ఆటా తరఫున అందరికీ హ్యాపీ ఉమెన్స్ డే. థ్యాంక్ యూ.